In this video, I will look at what can delay group policy settings from taking effect on your clients and what you can do to speed up the process and get more consistent results. First, I will look at the process that occurs when you make changes to group policy. Once the changes are made, these will need to be replicated. I will then look at how to force a replication if you do not want to wait. There are also some settings that I will look at which you can configure to speed up the process and give you a more consistent result. Lastly, I will look at forcing group policy to update by using the gpupdate command. Using gpupdate allows you to provide group policy on a client immediately rather than waiting for the next refresh. When you make changes to group policy, by default, the Group Policy Management Console will attempt to make the change on the domain controller holding the PDC Emulator operational master role. The administrator, however, can change this and make the changes on any domain controller they wish. If I open Group Policy Management Console from the Start menu, in order to change the domain controller that changes are being made on, all I will need to do is right-click the domain and select the option Change Domain Controller. You will notice that the option The Domain Controller with the Operations Master Token for the PDC Emulator is ticked by default. While this option is ticked, changes will be made on the Domain Controller with the PDC Emulator Operational Master role if it is available. If there is a slow link between you and the PDC Emulator, you may want to choose the second option, Any Available Domain Controller. This will cause the Group Policy Management Console to attempt to connect to an available domain controller in your site rather than going across a slow link to connect to the PDC emulator. The only concern when making changes from different domain controllers is that if two changes were made at different locations, there would be a replication conflict when replication occurred next. When this occurs, Active Directory uses the most recent change and discards the previous change. The next option, Any Available Domain Controller running Windows Server 2003 or later, will use a Windows Server 2003 domain controller rather than a low-level domain controller. If you are using a mixed environment, this is a good option to tick. Making group policy changes from a new client like Windows 7 to an old client like Windows Server 2000 can result in some unexpected results and are best to be avoided if possible. The last option lets you choose which domain controller you want to make the changes on. Regardless of which domain controller the changes are being made on, these changes need to be replicated to the domain controller that the client is authenticating off for the changes to take effect. In order for the new group policy to be available on the client, replication needs to occur for the Active Directory database and also the SysVol share. These are replicated using two different systems. If you want to push group policy changes out quickly, you can force a replication of these two different systems. If I want to force a replication of the Active Directory database, I can do this by opening Active Directory Sites and Services from the Start menu. To force a replication, expand down to the server that you want to force the replication from, and go into the NTDS Settings folder. From here, it is a matter of selecting the connection or connections that you want to force a replication on, right-clicking, and then selecting the option Replicate Now. You will notice that a dialog box will appear informing you that replication has been triggered, but you will need to use other tools to verify that the replication was successful. The same result can be achieved from the command prompt. If I close Active Directory Sites and Services, I can then open a command prompt from the Start menu. To force a replication from this domain controller to all its replication partners, run the command repadmin with the parameter /syncall. In some cases, you may have problems with synchronization between your domain controllers. To check for problems, you can run the command dcdiag. You can see that even though the last command ran without any errors, when dcdiag was run, some errors have been found. In this case, the RPC server is unavailable, and there have been 82 failures since the last replication. This problem is most likely because the server is not on or not contactable over the network. It is a good idea to check for replication problems using tools like these or to look in the event viewer. If replication is not working, then your clients are not getting group policy updates. The next part of group policy replications are the files contained in the SysVol folder. If you are using FRS to replicate SysVol, you can use the ntfrs util command. To force a replication, enter in the local computer name followed by the /r and then the set name. The set name in this case will be domain system volume SysVol share. The last parameter is /p followed by the DNS name of the domain controller that you want to replicate with. If you are using DFSR to replicate the SysVol share, you will need to use the DFSR diag command. The first parameter is sync now to indicate that a sync is to be performed. The next parameter is /partner : followed by the computer name you want to sync with. The next parameter /rg name indicates which data you want to sync. In this case, I will enter in : domain system volume for the SysVol folder. The last parameter /time indicates how long to ignore the current replication schedule. In this case, I have used 15 minutes. If the replication is not done in 15 minutes, it will revert to the current replication schedule. Once group policy replication has occurred, there are some issues which may prevent group policy from being applied. As we know from previous videos, group policy is applied when the computer starts up and when the user logs in. When a computer starts up, it may apply group policy before the networking has had a chance to start up and download the changed group policy. The end result is the user will log in with an old version of group policy. When the group policy refresh occurs, the new group policy will be applied. However, if changes can only be performed at startup, the computer will need to be restarted before changes can take effect, meaning two restarts need to be done. In a business environment, it is common for the administrator to want to have changes in group policy happen in a more predictable way. To do this, you can configure the following group policy settings. These settings effectively force the computer to wait for the networking to start before applying group policy. This gives the computer time to download and update group policy before applying it. Lastly, if you have made any changes to group membership, these changes will also need to replicate. If you use groups to filter group policy, if the change to group memberships have not replicated, it can affect who the group policy is applied to. Once group policy has updated, the computer will perform a refresh at certain intervals to check for changes. By default, this will occur between 90 and 120 minutes. If you want to change this, you can change it at the following location. There is one setting for regular computers and another setting for domain controllers. In the group policy setting, you have the option to add a random offset. Without a random offset, if all your client computers start up at the same time, they will attempt to update group policy at the same time, which could potentially cause performance problems for your network. If you consider the default settings, the group policy refresh is configured to 90 minutes with a random offset of 30 minutes. This is why the refresh happens between 90 and 120 minutes. If you want a refresh to happen right away, you can run the command gpupdate. Running gpupdate will trigger a background refresh of group policy. gpupdate by itself will only apply settings that have changed. If you want to ensure that all settings are applied regardless of whether they have changed or not, add /force parameter to the command. The force parameter will reapply all group policy settings even if they have not changed. If you only want to apply user or computer configuration, you can add /target followed by user or computer. If you are making changes only to one, this will reduce how long you have to wait to see the effects of the changes. In some cases, the changes may require a log off or reboot. gpupdate will prompt you when this occurs. However, if you want group policy to automatically log off the user or reboot the computer, you can add either the /logoff or /boot parameter. You can see that when you are making a lot of changes in group policy, GPUpdate is a useful tool to speed up the process. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.